to use that cool air that's contained down there to cool the entire museum. So here's an idea about the skin. It was a sort of a shingled skin that could let water through the repeating panels. Occasionally they can tip up to allow for natural ventilation, which is really unusual in a museum, but our folks at A10, so we can absolutely do it. So PVs all over the roof. It's a fairly complex little system. There's daylight coming through, there's PV, there's sunlight being harvested, there's air going through, and there's rain being harvested. So there are four things that the skin is trying to do. This is a diagram showing mass ventilation, water retention, so that's the pond that's pointing out. Under the parking structure were geothermal wells that would be used for the air conditioning, the active air conditioning. Lastly, we wanted the building to sort of acknowledge the fact that it's not in at the heart of the civil rights district, if you can call it that. There is a very famous street in Atlanta, Auburn Avenue, where Martin King was birthplaces and various historic moments. But the CCHR is in Coca-Cola, and so what we decided to do was to make a part of the museum that can go on tour can actually go down to Auburn Avenue. So literally a fragment of the museum pulls away. In fact, four of them. So we made these trailers that are glass, and they're both galleries from inside the museum. You can get them from inside the museum. Vitrines you can see from outside. And then they pull away and go to Auburn Avenue. There's one pulling away now. To actually take the museum to the neighborhood, to the civil rights district. And lastly,